Now, if you so-called men, you black males who want to go from boy to man, if you keep insisting on that, I'll make a deal with you. I will not allow you to ever be a man. Because there's only one man in this house. The house being the entire world. And that man is white. Okay? But if you black boys want to go from boyhood to manhood, I'm not going to let you. But I'll tell you, I'll make a deal. Tell you what I'm going to do. You can go from boy to woman.
Oh, no.
Now, if you put on a dress and start switching around like your sisters, and I'll have most of you raised up in a house full of nothing but females, so you'll learn how to put on the clothes and the lipstick and all of that. I mean, so sit there and watch your mother and your sister get dressed. You get dressed right alongside of them. I'll have maybe about 4 or 5 generations of you doing that. So you'll be real comfortable in walking behind your mothers and sisters looking just like them, acting just like them, twisting just like them, looking for a boyfriend like them. Because that's what you hear them talking about on the phone. My boyfriend, my boyfriend, my boyfriend. All right? And so, you'll be looking for some fella, a male, to come and pick you up and take you for a ride in your new high heels that you borrowed from your sister.
Oh, wow.
And you are a male. The white supremacists are very scientific in what they do. So, they got a lot of us hooked at an early age. And, you know, we all already know about the choirs and the church and all like that, see, and what all that's about. So they finance all of this. They support all of this. A couple of young white guys will move into the neighborhood, you might say, move across the street, right across from a black church. And they, you know, they move in and they are, you know, collegiate types. And they come over to the black church and they say, we would like to help you with your youth program. All right. And they got the money. I mean, and they know how to do things. They have talent. They come in there and they say, well, the way you're running your church, I mean, you know, it's not fostering anything. I mean, you're going to not have growth here. Well, we can start keeping your books, I mean, and show you how to grow your church. And, this lawn that you got out here, I mean, it's real, it's not well kept. I'm a horticulturist, and me and my buddy here, we can come over on weekends, and we can make this lawn, I mean, look really outstanding. I mean, when people come through the neighborhood, they will be amazed at how wonderful this place looks, because it's kind of run down, see, and they will volunteer, you know, and say, we're trying to help the community. We moved in here, and we want to help. And see, and then they get into, then they get in charge of the little boys program. So you want to know why your son is acting the way that he is when he comes home. I mean, he's beginning to act peculiarly. That's because these two white supremacists, which is what they are, when they do this type of thing, have infiltrated you right under your nose.
Well, I've got news for you. You are mine now. You belong to me.
Oh no, black people! Oh no! Oh no, black people! Faggot ass niggas!